Inside PressBox is presented by Live Casino and Hotel. Always live, always on.
And the U.S. Army Impact Player of the Month returns for its fifth year. Do you know a high school student athlete who impacts both their team and community? Nominate them today by going to PressBoxOnline.com/impact.
And join Glenn Clark and the NFL Chick on Facebook Live for Project Game Day, both at halftime and immediately following today's Ravens-Browns game. Project Game Day is live on Facebook/PressBox Sports and is presented by Glory Days Grill. Glen Burnie Transmissions provides factory remanufactured transmissions for hundreds less than the dealers. Suspect you have a transmission issue? Stop by for a complimentary road test and scan. You can easily get an estimate on your transmission repair by going to their website, gbt-online.com, or call 410-766-8500.
Do that, and welcome back into the show. The Maryland State Athletic Hall of Fame is having its induction ceremony November 8th. Our next guest is coming in as one of the greatest defensemen in the history of men's lacrosse. He led the Johns Hopkins Blue Jays to three straight national championships from 1978 to 80 and was a four-time All-American to boot. Let's welcome in Mark Greenberg, a Pikesville native. Welcome in. How are you?
Wonderful. Thank you.
Good to see you, Mark.
Nice to see you.
You know, so I've always wanted to ask a question of a Hall of Fame inductee, and that is, you spent all those years playing and giving yourself to the game as a player and learning the game. And I just wonder, you know, 30 years later, when you look back at that accomplishment as you go into the Hall of Fame, like, what are your thoughts in this time of your life?
Well, first of all, it's nice to be remembered at this time of my life about my past experiences. But more importantly, I think it's about, especially in the game of lacrosse, what you give back. And it's being able to look throughout the years and see what you've done over those years and how you've impacted people.
When you think back to those years, the three consecutive championships under Coach Ciccarone over there at Johns Hopkins University, what do you remember most about the team?
You know, there was, as earlier said, that, you know, there's an it. There's something special. And we all had this confidence and this family feel, and nobody was bigger than the program. So it was all about a team, and all we did was we wanted to work hard and we just wanted to win, and we came through with, at least during my career, only four losses. Pretty amazing.
That's pretty amazing.
You know, it's interesting to talk about that, and I do want to talk about your work with Israel lacrosse in a minute, but just on the four losses in 4 years and the three championships, it seems to me that with the growth of the sport, it's much harder for a program to do that today, because there's so much talent out there and the talent is going to so many different places, as opposed to back in the 70s when Hopkins was clearly the center of it all and the universe was much more compact. So I wonder from your perspective about the growth of the sport.
Well, first of all, the growth of the sport is phenomenal. I mean, it's a great thing for the sport, both in this country and worldwide. And we're seeing international players come over to the United States to play as well. So that's really helping the growth of the game as well. I would tell you that I think that it's more difficult, without a question, to have that consistency for long-term championships and for winning programs, just because it's hard to keep those kids, and they're coming from all over the place. And it's they're special players. With the equipment today, I mean, it's very easy to be a great player, but to be so many of them, it's really special.
Your induction coming up in November, early November, is it the 7th or 8th?
It's the 8th.
The 8th, okay. And I'm a member of the board there. Tell us a little bit about what this means to you. I know you said it's great to be remembered, but you're going in with some pretty impressive names.
So when I first got the call, I'm thinking, you know, what does this mean to me? And meaning was not just about lacrosse. I know I've made a place in the lacrosse world, but to be representing a lacrosse player in for the state with, you know, a pro basketball player and a pro football player, it's a world-class sailor. It's amazing for me to be put on another, you know, threshold. So special.
Mark, internationally, lacrosse is basically a newbie. Israel especially has always been a basketball and a soccer country. Tell me about the growth of Israel lacrosse and how you became involved in it, and why are they taking to the game in the first place?
Well, you said soccer and basketball. I think those are naturals for going to lacrosse. A young man approached myself and three others back in 2011 and said that he wanted to make lacrosse the national sport of Israel, because in Israel, they're going to play basketball well, they're going to play soccer well, but they're never going to win a national championship or world championship. With lacrosse, they have a potential because it's an easy sport to pick up and people gravitate to it very easily. And so that's what we've done, and it's taken another whole world, as it does in every community. Lacrosse is really works with at-risk youth. It brings people who didn't have a connection to have a family, and that has been phenomenal for Israel to do. All
right. Mark, fabulous. Thank you very much for coming in.
Congratulations on everything.
Thank you.
We'll see you over there at Martin's West on November 8th, and congratulations again.
Thank you.
After the break, where are they now? Well, we'll look at players the Orioles sent off at the deadline in our Costas In Photo of the Week.
Royal Farms World Famous Chicken has been ranked number one in Food & Wine magazine. Royal Farms, real fresh, real fast.
Inside PressBox is presented by Live Casino and Hotel. Always live, always on.